Hello, everyone. Welcome to the English devotional from Soldiers of the Cross. Let's open in prayer. Heavenly Father, I come before you, giving you thanks and giving you praise for being a good God, a faithful God, a merciful God. Thank you for the sacrifice of your Son on the cross more than 2,000 years ago. Thank you that we can have forgiveness of our sins and that your mercy is new for us every morning. Father, I ask that if there is anything in my heart, in my mind, and my soul, any actions that I have done that do not please you, that you will forgive me of all of my sins and offenses and wash me as white as snow. Father, as we have embarked on this new year, help us to dedicate more and more time to you, even if it's just 5 minutes more a day to dedicate to you. May we purpose in our heart to please you in all that we do and to make small changes that amount to big changes. Father, transform our lives. Allow us to be living testimonies for you. Allow our words to edify and encourage other people. Allow our actions to bring more people to your kingdom. Father God, we worship, we adore you. We lay our lives before you and we surrender to you. In Jesus' name, amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Today's devotional is titled, Nobody. It was written by Sergio Gonzalez and translated by Maria Elena Cardona and Ezequias Hernandez. Our biblical base today is found in Matthew chapter 10, verses 16 through 20. So says the word of God. Behold, I send you out as sheep in the midst of wolves. Therefore, be wise as serpents and harmless as doves. But be aware of men, for they will deliver you up to councils and scourge you in their synagogues. You will be brought before governors and kings for my sake, as a testimony to them and to the Gentiles. But when they deliver you up, do not worry about how or what you should speak, for it will be given to you in that hour what you should speak. For it is not you who speak, but the Spirit of your Father who speaks in you. Amen. May we be blessed by the reading of the Scripture. Homer may not have known Jesus, but our Savior could know about his poetry. Whenever I read that quote, wise as serpents, I remember the Odyssey as a practical example. Back in Ithaca, Ulysses, the victor of Troy, was thrown by a storm on an island where the legendary Cyclopses lived. A Cyclops named Polyphemus that lived in a cave was prepared to eat the men that the storm had brought. When the Cyclops asked Ulysses what his name was, he said that Nobody was his name. So when Ulysses was able to blind the Cyclops with a sharp spear after making the immense creature drunk, the Cyclops' neighbor did not understand his accusation when Polyphemus kept saying, "Nobody hurt me with deceit, not with force." Even when life brings us challenges, lying is not the solution. We must seek the truth with the wisdom we were given as a gift from our Creator. We are rational beings who were created with the ability to use wisdom to face the evils that surround us and the traps that the adversary hides. To be wise is to be a sharp being. Wise to avoid being deceived, among other definitions. That's what Jesus was referring to when he said, "Be wise as serpents." You must pay attention to the steps you take because sometimes the ground is camouflaged and it will seem like you tread on solid ground. However, there is a void full of spears waiting for you to fall on. Don't think that you are strong on your own. Those who have true strength are the ones who have trusted God and have turned away even from the appearance of evil. Nothing justifies sin. Even if you think so, use your wisdom, and as Ulysses in the Odyssey, blind with the spear of wisdom the evil's eye. Amen. My brothers and sisters, we must be vigilant to stay away from sin. We must be vigilant to watch for the traps that the devil sets before us. They could come when we least expect it. They can come hidden and camouflaged as something good, but it turns to be something terrible and something that causes us to stumble and fall. It could be a thought that comes in our head that we don't rebuke and that we allow to stay in our minds and dwell on them. The enemy is cunning and he is sneaky. But my brothers and sisters, God has given us a gift of wisdom so that we can be wise as serpents and gentle as doves. My brother, with the power of the Holy Spirit, with Jesus as our guide with his righteous right hand, we can avoid the enemy's snares and traps. We can have victory in the name of Jesus. And if we have fallen into one of his traps, that's not the end of your story, my brother and sister. We can have redemption through the blood of his Son, Jesus Christ. Claim your victory today. Claim your redemption story today. Amen. May the Lord receive the honor and the glory.
Of your sovereignty.
What a beautiful song. All wisdom belongs to God. And now we invite you to continue listening to our daily Bible reading, which can be found in Genesis chapter 9, 10, and 11. So says the Word of God. Genesis chapter 9. So God blessed Noah and his sons and said to them, "Be fruitful and multiply and fill the earth. And the fear of you and the dread of you shall be on every beast of the earth, on every bird of the air, on all that move on the earth, and on all the fish of the sea. They are given into your hand. Every moving thing that lives shall be food for you. I have given you all things, even as the green herbs, but you shall not eat flesh with its life, that is, its blood. Surely, for your lifeblood, I will demand a reckoning. From the hand of every beast I will require it, and from the hand of man, from the hand of every man's brother, I will require the life of man. Whoever sheds man's blood, by man his blood shall be shed. For in the image of God he made man. And as for you, be fruitful and multiply, bring forth abundantly in the earth, and multiply in it." Then God spoke to Noah and to his sons with him, saying, "As for me, behold, I will establish my covenant with you, and with your descendants after you, and with every living creature that is with you, the birds, the cattle, and every beast of the earth with you, of all that go out of the ark, every beast of the earth. Thus I establish my covenant with you. Never again shall all flesh be cut off by the waters of the flood. Never again shall there be a flood to destroy the earth." And God said, "This is the sign of the covenant which I make between me and you and every living creature that is with you for perpetual generations. I set my rainbow in the cloud, and it shall be for the sign of the covenant between me and the earth. It shall be when I bring a cloud over the earth that the rainbow shall be seen in the cloud. And I will remember my covenant, which is between me and you and every living creature of all flesh. The water shall never again become a flood to destroy all flesh. The rainbow shall be in the cloud, and I will look on it to remember the everlasting covenant between God and every living creature of all flesh that is on the earth." And God said to Noah, "This is the sign of the covenant which I have established between me and all flesh that is on the earth." Now the sons of Noah, who went out of the ark, were Shem, Ham, and Japheth. And Ham was the father of Canaan. These three were the sons of Noah, and from these the whole earth was populated. And Noah began to be a farmer, and he planted a vineyard. Then he drank of the wine, and was drunk, and became uncovered in his tent. And Ham, the father of Canaan, saw the nakedness of his father, and told his two brothers outside. But Shem and Japheth took a garment, laid it on both their shoulders, and went backwards, and covered the nakedness of their father. Their faces were turned away, and they did not see their father's nakedness. So Noah awoke from his wine, and he knew what his younger son had done to him. Then he said, "Cursed be Canaan, a servant of servants, he shall be to his brethren." And he said, "Blessed be the Lord, the God of Shem, and may Canaan be his servant. May God enlarge Japheth, and may he dwell in the tents of Shem, and may Canaan be his servant." And Noah lived after the flood 350 years. So all the days of Noah were 950 years, and he died. Genesis chapter 10. This is the account of Shem, Ham, and Japheth, Noah's sons, who themselves had sons after the flood. The sons of Japheth, Gomer, Magog, Madai, Javan, Tubal, Meshech, and Tiras. The sons of Gomer, Ashkenaz, Riphath, and Togarmah. The sons of Javan, Elisha, Tarshish, and the Kittites, and the Rodanites. From these the maritime people spread out into their territories by their clans within their nations, each with its own language. The sons of Ham, Cush, Egypt, Put, and Canaan. The sons of Cush, Sheba, Havilah, Sabta, Ramah, and Sabteca. The sons of Ramah, Sheba, and Dedan. Cush was the father of Nimrod, who became a mighty warrior on the earth. He was a mighty hunter before the Lord. That is why it is said, "Like Nimrod, a mighty hunter before the Lord." The first centers of his kingdom were Babylon, Uruk, Akkad, and Calneh in Shinar. From that land he went to Assyria, where he built Nineveh, Rehoboth, Ir, Calal, and Rezin, which is between Nineveh and Calal, which is the great city. Egypt was the father of the Ludites, Ammonites, Lehavites, Naphtuhites, Pathrusites, Casluhites, from whom the Philistines came, and Kaphtorites. Canaan was the father of Sidon, his firstborn, and of the Hittites, Jebusites, Amorites, Girgashites, Hivites, Arkites, Zinites, Arvadites, Zemarites, and Hamathites. Later, the Canaanite clans scattered, and the borders of Canaan reached from Sidon to Gerar, as far as Gaza, and then toward Sodom, Gomorrah, Admah, and Zeboiim, as far as Lasha. These are the sons of Ham, by their clans and languages, in their territories and nations. Sons were also born to Shem, whose older brother was Japheth. Shem was the ancestor of all the sons of Eber. The sons of Shem, Elam, Asher, Arphaxad, Lud, and Aram. The sons of Aram, Uz, Hul, Jether, and Meshech. Arphaxad was the father of Selah, and Selah the father of Eber. Two sons were born to Eber. One was named Peleg, because in his time the earth was divided. His brother was named Joktan. Joktan was the father of Almadad, Seleph, Hazarmoveth, Jera, Hadaram, Uzal, Dikla, Obal, Abiamiel, Sheba, Orphir, Havilah, and Joabab. These were the sons of Joktan. The region where they lived stretched from Mesha toward Sephar in the eastern hill country. These are the sons of Shem by their clan and languages in their territories and nations. These are the clans of Noah's sons according to their lines of descent within their nations. From these the nations spread out over the earth after the flood. Genesis chapter 11. Now the whole world had one language and a common speech. As people moved eastward, they found a plain in Shinar and settled there. They said to each other, "Come, let's make bricks and bake them thoroughly." They used brick instead of stone and tar for mortar. Then they said, "Come, let us build ourselves a city with a tower that reaches to the heavens so that we may make a name for ourselves. Otherwise, we will be scattered over the face of the whole earth." But the Lord came down to see the city and the tower the people were building. The Lord said, "If as one people speaking the same language, they have begun to do this, then nothing they plan to do will be impossible for them. Come, let us go down and confuse their language so they will not understand each other." So the Lord scattered them from there over all the earth, and they stopped building the city. That is why it was called Babel, because there the Lord confused the language of the whole world. From there, the Lord scattered them over the face of the whole earth. This is the account of Shem's family line. 2 years after the flood, when Shem was 100 years old, he became the father of Arphaxad. And after he became the father of Arphaxad, Shem lived 500 years and had other sons and daughters. When Arphaxad had lived 35 years, he became the father of Shelah. And after he became the father of Shelah, Arphaxad lived 403 years and had other sons and daughters. When Shelah lived 30 years, he became the father of Eber. And after he became the father of Eber, Shelah lived 403 years and had other sons and daughters. When Eber had lived 34 years, he became the father of Peleg. And after he became the father of Peleg, Eber lived 430 years and had other sons and daughters. When Peleg had lived 30 years, he became the father of Reu. And after he became the father of Reu, Peleg lived 209 years and had other sons and daughters. When Reu had lived 32 years, he became the father of Serug. And after he became the father of Serug, Reu lived 207 years and had other sons and daughters. When Serug had lived 30 years, he became the father of Nahor. And after he became the father of Nahor, Serug lived 200 years and had other sons and daughters. When Nahor had lived 29 years, he became the father of Terah. And after he became the father of Terah, Noah lived 119 years and had other sons and daughters. And after Terah had lived 70 years, he became the father of Abram, Nahor, and Haran. Amen. May we be blessed by the reading of the scripture. And now we ask that the blessed love of God, the grace and peace of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the companion and communion of the Holy Spirit, our great counselor, be with all of his children, now and forever. Amen.